So today's video is kind of an extension on a video I made back in the day when I first started making minimalism videos, and it's all about the things that I stopped buying, except that video didn't go into too much detail and there's lots of things I missed out. And I wanted to talk a little bit more about how all of these things saved me a lot of money. Minimalism really does and has saved me a lot of money since I have embarked on it. So just a little disclaimer before I get into the video, because I made a video called 50 Things to Get Rid Of in 2018 and I definitely ruffled a few feathers. So I just wanted to say this is not a video telling you what to do or instructions or rules, it's just a video with some advice, some ideas, some thoughts, hopefully so that you'll get inspired to maybe rethink some purchases you're making or reduce your consumption of things, and fingers crossed you'll save money in the process. So take it with a pinch of salt and adjust according to your lifestyle and your needs and what makes you happy. So without further ado, let's get into it. So the first area of things that I've stopped buying as much of that has saved me so much money is beauty products. I started to look into natural beauty and making my own back when I first started learning about minimalism and I was decluttering. I realized I had an overwhelming amount of stuff that I didn't use and I didn't need. And yeah, I have a whole ebook on it called Minimal Beauty. So if you're watching this video, I'm giving you a 10% off discount code. I will leave it here and link in the description so you can make your own too. I also embarked on No Poo back in the day when I first started learning about minimalism, which is essentially no shampoo. I know it's a horrible phrase, it doesn't mean I don't poo, and it just means using natural alternatives on your hair. So one of the first things I did was stop using conditioner. My hair type just doesn't really need conditioner and it does really well using a natural shampoo and not much else at all. So that moves on to the second thing, which is post-wash hair products. I used to use an array of them, so things like frizzies, hairsprays, leave-in conditioners, mousses, and I don't use any of those things anymore. I just use argan oil on my hair if it's a little bit frizzy. The third thing is makeup remover wipes and cotton pads. I lived off of these at university when I'd come home after a few too many drinks and I had just no energy to take my makeup off, but now I use flannels and I just wash them after I take my makeup off. The fourth thing is earbuds, or Q-tips I think Americans call it. My mum told me this when I was younger. I think her doctor advised her that she shouldn't be using earbuds because it can cause problems. You shouldn't be putting something in your ear. So I've just kind of held onto that and I don't buy them. Next is fun, gimmicky, experimental makeup. I've moved out of that phase of my life where I play around with makeup and I have colourful lipsticks and eyeshadows. I definitely had that phase and I was sucked into the YouTube beauty guru world where I bought a lot of makeup, but I just don't do that anymore and I just stick to what I know, which is some kind of natural look like this. Number six is face wash, toner and moisturiser. As I said, I make my own beauty products now, so I don't use those things and I don't purchase those things. I bulk buy oils and then make my own little concoctions, which I have recipes for in my ebook. So I use an oil cleanser to take my makeup off, I use a facial oil to moisturise, and I have a little mix of powders as an exfoliator, and that's kind of it when it comes to my skincare regime. Another thing is dry shampoo. As I mentioned, the whole no poo thing, I stopped washing my hair as much and my hair got used to cleaning itself and not getting greasy so fast, so I didn't have the need for dry shampoo anymore. Number eight is foundation. So I stopped buying foundation quite a long time ago actually, because I just started to prefer a more natural look and to let my skin breathe a bit. So I just use concealer and BB cream on my skin now and I much prefer it, and I think my skin does too. So next is shower gel. Instead I now use bar soap. It's a lot more versatile. It usually doesn't come in any packaging, or I buy it without any plastic packaging, and it lasts a lot longer, so it's a lot cheaper. Number 10 is shaving foam. So instead of shaving foam, I use things like aloe vera, coconut oil, or just soap. Those things are all versatile ingredients that I can use for other things, and it's not a single purpose product, and therefore it saves money. Another thing is mouthwash. I was never really a mouthwash person growing up, but then everyone around me when I was at uni was using mouthwash, so I kind of felt like I had to. So I started using it, and I think when I started learning about minimalism, I was like, this is something again that I don't think that I need, so I stopped buying it. Number 12 is plastic toothbrushes. I do technically still have a plastic toothbrush, except it's an electric toothbrush and it lasts a lot longer. I got sent this toothbrush by a company, Vanity Planet. I think close to 2 years ago, and it's still going strong. I haven't had to replace the heads because it came with a packet of them. I do have a discount code, I think, from them when I first got sent it, so I'll link that down below. Another thing that I don't buy anymore is dental floss. I have one of those things that shoots water through your teeth. My boyfriend had it and now I just use it, so that saves some money. And finally, the last beauty item is disposable plastic razors. I still have a razor, but it's made from metal. It's from a brand called Cornerstone. And the heads are made out of plastic, but they last a lot longer. It's just a way higher quality razor, and I want to make the switch to a safety razor soon because that's even less waste, and I'm sure that it will save me money in the long run. Moving on to household items, one of the things that I ditched when I moved out of home was kitchen towel. My parents used to use kitchen towel, and lots of people use kitchen towel or paper towels, but I never really understood the purpose of them when you can just use a cloth. Another thing is really specific cleaners, like bathroom cleaner, kitchen cleaner, toilet cleaner. I now make my own cleaners, and I have a video on that if you want to check that out. It saves a lot of money, and all the ingredients that go into the cleaners are multi-purpose ingredients that I can use across the board for a variety of things. Number 17 is plastic bags. I don't ever buy plastic bags because I bring my own. Another thing is home decor and trinkets. The only things that really decorate my home are plants and candles and diffusers. I really like it that way. When I first moved into my own home, I felt tempted to go out and buy all these cute little things for my home because they are really cute and pretty, but I find that they end up costing a lot of money, and also they just clutter everything up. Fabric softener is another thing that I don't buy anymore just because I don't think it's needed. I think that it's an extra additional cost that we just don't need. Number 20 is air freshener. I make my own air freshener just out of some water and essential oil. It does the job, and again, it's a multi-purpose item because the ingredients, the essential oil, I can use for other things. The last household item that I don't buy anymore is disposable sponges and cloths. I have ones that I can use over and over again. When they're dirty, I just throw them in the washing machine and they're good as new. So the next big area for me was clothes and accessories. I was a huge shopaholic. I had a real problem here, and I decluttered my whole wardrobe and realized I needed to give up a lot of things that I'm buying all the time because this is not healthy for me. So one of the first things that I gave up was fast fashion. I no longer follow trends or buy things that are trending or cool right now. I just avoid all of that and just stick to practical clothes. Not to mention the impact that fast fashion has on the planet, the fact that it's super wasteful, and there's a lot of human rights issues. I now instead shop secondhand and go with brands that are ethical and sustainable. Following on from this, I've given up single wear items. I used to always buy dresses and shoes and items to just wear for one event or one party, and I don't do that anymore. I try and get things that I can wear over and over again. It's really tempting to buy clothes that are on sale that you don't need, so I don't subscribe to any email lists that tell me when things are on sale, and I just buy things when I need them rather than when they're reduced. Number 25 is overly impractical clothes or shoes, so things like really uncomfortable high heels and really uncomfortable dresses. I have worn them all, and I'm now at a stage in my life where practical and comfy clothes is all I want. Number 26 is jewellery. I only wear this one single piece of jewellery, and I got rid of all my costume jewellery, and I only have a little box of a few kind of sentimental things that I've been handed down by my family. Number 27 is handbags. I used to, again, have a lot of handbags, and now I think I only have two. Maybe three, no, two. And I more often than not, I'm wearing a backpack instead just because it's a bit more practical. And the final clothing item I stopped buying is high heels. I do have one very small, modest pair of high heels for occasions like weddings and stuff, but I had upwards of maybe 40, 50 pairs of heels and I had to get rid of them all. It was very hard because that's a lot of money, but I just don't need them. I'm 5'11". I'm not partying or going out drinking anymore, and I'm not about that high heel life anymore. So moving on now to tech. The first thing is CDs and DVDs. I instead stream everything on things like Spotify, Netflix, Amazon Prime, and YouTube. 31 is poor quality tech. I find 9 times out of 10, if I buy something cheaply, it's probably just gonna break sooner and then I'm gonna have to buy a new one. So I try and save my money a few months in advance and buy the more expensive option. I know this isn't available to everybody if you're on a budget, but if you can, do try and get the more expensive one because it'll probably last you a lot longer. And this also moves me on to secondhand tech. So if you're on a budget and you can't afford the more expensive option, try and get it secondhand. My camera's secondhand, my lens is secondhand. This Apple Watch I got recently is secondhand. My Bose headphones were secondhand, and we saved a lot of money buying those things. Number 33 is gimmicky tech. I think there's lots of new tech things coming out all the time, and it makes you feel like you need to buy them, but you really don't. I've made that mistake of buying something and then regretting it afterwards because I really didn't need it. Number 34 is pricey games and apps. I don't have games or anything that really costs me any money on my phone. I used to, and it was a waste of money, honestly. And the last tech thing is batteries. I have rechargeable batteries now, which is a lot cheaper and better for the environment. So another thing is food and drink, and I'm gonna start with animal products. I'm vegan, so I don't buy animal products, and I found that it has saved me a lot of money. I went vegan when I was a student at university, and it just meant that a big chunk of my weekly food shop I wasn't buying anymore, and actually the most expensive part, which was meat and dairy. And a lot of the time, actually, before I was even vegan, I used to not buy meat for the week because I couldn't afford it. So for me, it worked out a lot cheaper because things like potatoes, rice, fruit and veg are cheaper than meat in the UK. I know it's different for everybody, and don't get me wrong here, everyone's circumstances are different, but definitely lowering the amount of animal products in your diet should save you some money. Number 37 is bottled water. I take my own with me everywhere I go. I feel like I have done for as long as I can remember, but now I just don't buy bottled water out pretty much ever. I can't remember the last time that I did. So bring your own, it's better for the environment and it's cheaper, like all the things on this list. Another thing is alcohol. So I gave up alcohol a couple years ago. I used to be a big binge drinker, and boy, do I save a lot of money not drinking alcohol. Number 39 is multiples. So when I go to the shop and something's on offer, often you feel tempted to buy it and get multiples of it because it's cheap right now. I really try not to do that because often it means I buy more of something and spend more money on something that I really probably wouldn't otherwise buy. Number 40 and 41 is takeaway coffee and tea and takeaway food. I work from home, I don't drink coffee, so I very rarely go out and get myself a cup of tea or coffee. It doesn't happen. In fact, I can't remember a time it's happened in the last year. And similarly with takeaway food, I only really eat takeaway food if I'm traveling or if I'm with friends, and it tends to be like lunchtime. I don't like order takeaway food in at home. I love cooking, and I just find it's really expensive to do that. So if you're spending a lot of money on takeaway food, I have lots of recipes on my channel and on my website. I'll link my most recent video up here and do some meal prepping. The last food item is pre-prepared foods like sliced up fruit and veg. I used to get the packets of stir-fry veg, and I don't anymore. I just cut them up myself because it saves money and it's better for the environment. I've said that so many times. You get the gist. And the last set of things are just things that didn't fit into the other categories, honestly. Starting with a menstrual cup. I don't buy tampons or sanitary towels anymore because I use a menstrual cup. I use a moon cup, and yeah, it's changed my life. It is incredible. It's so much more convenient for me. It's just a little silicone cup that you use when you're on your period. It holds the blood and then you rinse it out. It just saves money and so much waste. Number 44 is duplicates. Minimalism has definitely taught me a lot when it comes to buying 2, 3, 4 of the same thing that you already have. If I've already got it at home, I really try my hardest to use it until it's broken. I'm not always perfect at this, and sometimes I'm tempted by buying something new and pretty, but I really try not to buy duplicates. Number 45 is books. I have a library card now, so I don't buy any books and I try and borrow them. I've been borrowing a lot of books from friends and family, and it's been working out really well for me so far. So similarly, magazines, I just don't buy them anymore. I used to love magazines, but I think the way that we consume media has changed now, and it's all online. 47 is souvenirs. If I'm traveling, I don't feel tempted to go to the gift shop to go and buy something so I can bring it home as a memory or to give as a gift to a family member or friend. Number 48 is multiple phone cases. I just have this one on my phone. I used to have multiple ones I could switch out, but I like this one, so I just stick to this one. Number 49, we're nearly at the end of the list. I hope this video has been fast. It's branded items. So I try not to be swayed by a name and instead be swayed by the quality of a product, because a lot of brand names, you are just spending money for that brand name. You're not actually spending money for higher quality, and you can get really, really good quality things without a brand name, and that saves money. Finally, number 50 is things that are on sale, things with coupon codes. I know I mentioned this when it comes to clothes, but when it comes to anything, I try not to buy things on sale when it's Black Friday and stuff, because it does really tempt me, as someone who is inherently a shopaholic, tempts me to go and buy things that I don't need. So that is it. Those are the 50 things that I've stopped buying. I think that's everything. I couldn't think of anything else other than those 50. Let me know in the comments down below what you've stopped buying since you've started to be more minimal, or what you aim to stop buying, and the things that are your Achilles heel that you need to work on. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.
Every time it gets me. Am I gonna use this footage?